Joe. We need some new episodes.
Maybe something quantum.
Airplanes, how do they fly? It's magic, right?
Yogurt or yoga?
Segways, who made them? Can we get rid of them all?
Hopefully. How about bicycles? I think
bicycles are good.
Tricycles.
Who invented the bike?
Cartoons are big.
Physics of cartoons?
Why doesn't he fall down?
Goats are rambunctious and playful and hilarious and cute, but what is going on with their eyes? They're part Kermit the Frog, part squid, part I don't even know. Like most other ungulates, goats have horizontal rectangular pupils. Along with their eyes being on the side of their head, those slits let goats make out detail and depth perception nearly 360 degrees around their whole body. Now this makes sense if you spend most of your life out in the open exposed to predators, but there's a trade-off to horizontal pupils. They can't see well on the vertical axis, so if you're gonna sneak up on a goat, do it from above. Goats, what's up with the fainting? Sure, it's cute, makes good YouTube video, but that is not how you goat. Fainting goats aren't actually fainting, they remain conscious the whole time. But thanks to a hereditary genetic disorder, their muscles fail to relax after contracting thanks to this mutation in a muscle chloride channel. This condition, also seen in some humans and cats and dogs, is set off when they're panicked or scared. So stop sneaking up on goats already. Or don't, it's actually kind of adorable. Goats love standing on stuff, anything. Sheet metal, cows, trampolines, pigs, basically if it's a thing, a goat will stand on it. They develop their climbing ability because of their previous mentioned inability to see above or below. But it's also to gain access to food that's out of the reach of other grazers and to avoid predators, because it's pretty hard to attack a goat on a completely vertical wall. Goats get their awesome climbing skills thanks to their special two-toed hooves. The pads of these hooves are soft and grippy, and they can spread out to sort of disperse the goat's weight on a variety of surfaces. Their ninja-like ability makes sense since domestic goats were descended from the mountain goats of Zagros, which sounds like a metal band from Game of Thrones. Goats can make a wide variety of noises, but there's no evidence they can that they can actually mimic human speech. Rather, our brains are just so fine-tuned to pick out language that we can't help but hear words in their maniacal screams. Researchers at Queen Mary University in London did report that goats can develop certain accents in their voices if they move to a different goat group. In terms of adaptable animal voices, this puts them in the select company of humans, dolphins, elephants, and Madonna, that time she moved to England. They say goats will eat anything. Now, while they probably wouldn't go chomping on explosives, goats are browsing herbivores, meaning that they are curious eaters who will taste pretty much anything that resembles plant matter. Goats actually have nearly twice the taste buds that we do, but seem to have a high tolerance for bitter, sometimes toxic plants. They'll eat cotton clothing or even paper.
Joe. Joe, you fell asleep. Joe, are you okay?
Whoa. I just had the weirdest dream. We did an entire episode about goats.
Was it any good?
It was bad!